A heavy heart because we lost somebody that's from GI. And the most shocking thing about it is that it's hard to believe. We can't grasp this fact that he's dead. That's the hardest part of missing Michael, to believe that this man we just saw here is not with us anymore. But we will forever hold his music inside of us. I have 25 girlfriends from his music that I will never forget. And I'm, because of the music that I see all the time, I think I'll rekindle 22 of them. So it's an exciting time for all of us, and I'm happy to be home again.
Hey, tonight we're at Club Suave celebrating the life of a legend, Michael Jackson. Remembering the legacy of Michael Jackson, and we're so lucky to have one of Gary's favorite sons, if not the favorite son, right here at Club Suave with us, Fred the Hammer Williamson.
Yo, what's up, my man? Look, people see us together so much that they think I'm following you around, but you seem to be winding up at all the best places, so I'm going to keep following you around, dude.
Well, you know, it goes with the territory, because I learned one thing: if I can hold on to your coat, young man, I'm going to go a long ways.
Yeah, that's the game. That's the name of the game. Right. So, you got to really keep up with me, though, man, but following you, it's a pleasure. You know, Suave, nice place. I just had some chicken.
Okay.
They got chicken here too, dude. Real good.
So you would endorse coming back here, right?
Oh, yeah.
This is a great place. And I'll tell you one thing, Fred and myself, tomorrow, we're remembering tonight the legend, Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was undoubtedly the king of pop. We're going to be remembering him tomorrow at the Genesis Center in Gary, Indiana. We're even in better luck tonight to have the hottest stepping sound right here with us in Slick. Slick is an artist that has been around for a few minutes, long time. I think he's ancient. I don't know. But you're in for a real treat.
Come on, y'all. Put your hands together.
Body,
I wanna do it again.
Caressing your body. play it.
Fred, let me ask you one question, and I've asked all of my guests tonight. What influence did Michael Jackson music have on you?
Well, it's not. Obviously, the music had a lot of influence on me. I dated a lot of girls and got over big time with a lot of ladies on Michael's music. But the main thing is what's overlooked is what it took him, myself, and other people who have been successful.
Right.
Coming out of Gary with all the negative things that hold you back and hold you down. I guarantee you, nobody ever said to Michael, go do that. You can do that. Everybody tells you what you can't do. In my life, in this small community, in this town, people always tell you what you can't do. So when you do become something and become success, it is a big job. It is a hard job. It takes a lot of money and a lot of time and a lot of effort to do it. So the point is, I don't want some kid to feel that he can become a star just because Michael became a star or because I'm successful. It takes a lot of hard work. It takes a lot of dedication. And obviously, you have to be good.
You know, Fred, I'm glad you said that because the determination is the first thing. You believe in yourself. But you know, you need a person to kind of keep you in order as well. In the community that we came up in, the parent was the parent. They controlled you, and they made sure that you did what you had to do. And if you needed a whooping, my friend, you got that whooping. So, you know, I look at all the positive things that came out of direction. Yes, Michael Jackson probably did not have a great childhood because he was always out there performing or ready to perform because his father and his mother wanted him to achieve greatness. Now, we're lucky that Fred Williamson, who has no blemishes in his life, is a spokesman for the city of Gary. If you really want to see what success is about without any blemish, then you're looking at this right here in Fred the Hammer Williamson. And we're so proud to have him here with us tonight at Club Suave. One thing he's always told me, I am where I am needed. And Fred, thanks again. And I'd like to say one more thing about Rudy's interview the last night.
Mayor Clay. Thank you very much,
Frank.
Yeah, my buddy.
That's right.
Mayor Rudolph Clay.
All right, Gary.
Go ahead.
Tell me about the interview last night that he had on Larry King Live.
No, he expressed himself about the love that the people of Gary had for him because he came from Gary. He was Gary's own. We have a different kind of love for Michael Jackson. Our love is that he is one of our citizens who came through and made it big. It's not just about his music, it's about the man who is from GI.
The Honorable Mayor Rudolph Clay.
Thank you. Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank God for being the mayor of Gary, Indiana, my hometown at this time and place in history. They sung a song, you know, that we are the world. But in Gary, Indiana, we are the children that was raised with Michael Jackson, and on July 10th, Friday, we're going to have a memorial celebration for the world's greatest entertainer, our favorite son, Michael Jackson, at the baseball stadium. So we're inviting everybody to come out. Don't miss this one. And we're also going to build a fabulous museum here in Gary, Indiana, in honor of Michael Jackson, so that the whole world will forever know that Michael Jackson was the greatest entertainer. We loved him. Because if they can do it for Elvis Presley, yeah, we can do it for Michael.
Because there's no wrong or right. Just move and let your body decide. To have fun is the key, so you go and be free. If you're moving, then you're all right with me. Just partying, day and night, yeah, I'm joining me. out of town. Feel the music, come on, let's get down. Let the music play.